subscribe now and press the bell icon. Never miss an update.
Hello everyone. Hope you all are good. In today's video, I will show deflection calculation of 48 feet RCC beam using effective moment of inertia inclusive of instantaneous deflection due to service load and then long-term deflection. I will calculate three different beams due to its variation of catchment length, or I can say load acting on beam according to its structural framing. This is mezzanine floor framing of masjid. I take this beam size of 24x36. UDL load will act on this beam only from one side, another side of beam have no slab. So catchment length on beam is half of length 9.58 feet, that is 4.79 feet.
Now let's first calculate which and how much load is acting on this beam as UDL. I have span of beam as 48 feet. Concrete compressive strength FC is equal to 3 KSI or 3000 PSI. Reinforcement yield strength, FY, is equal to 60 KSI. Since this is masjid, so live load acting on floor is 100 PSF or 0.1 kip per square foot. Floor finish load is 30 PSF or 0.03 kip per square foot. Catchment length I am already calculated as 4.79 feet. I am using beam size of 24 inches by 36 inches. This was one-way discontinuous slab from both sides, so thickness of slab is equal to L20, where L is one-way span of slab, so it is 9.58 by 12 20ths equals to 5.75. So I am using 6 inches thick slab thickness. Slab load will be density of concrete, which is 0.15 kip per cubic foot by slab thickness, which is 6 inches or 0.5 feet equals to 0.075 kip per square foot. First I am calculating slab self-weight acting on beam, equals to slab load, which is 0.075 k per square foot by catchment length, that is 4.79 feet equals to 0.36 kip per foot. Floor finish load acting on beam equals to finish load, which is 0.036 kip per square foot by catchment length, which is 4.79 feet equals to 0.15 kip per foot. Live load acting on beam, equals to live load of 0.1 kip per square foot by catchment length, which is 4.79 feet equals to 0.48 kip per foot. Beam self-weight is concrete density, which is 0.15 kip per cubic foot by cross-sectional area of beam, which is 24x36, 144, in which 144 is conversion factor from N2 to FT2. Result of this equals to 0.9 kip per foot. Service load will be 1.0 dead load plus 1.0 live load. Add all loads and it equals to 1.89 kip per foot. Ultimate load will be 1.2 dead load plus 1.6 live load. Result of this equals to 2.46 kip per foot. This ultimate load I will use in calculating ultimate moment, then using that moment I will calculate reinforcing steel require in beam.
Let's calculate deflection now using data of this beam. It's my Excel sheet which I made to calculate instantaneous and long-term deflection of pinned end beam having UDL load. Input beam size to 24 inch by 36 inch. FC prime equals 3 KSI and phi equals 60 KSI. Depth of tension reinforcement is 33 inch, which I can calculate subtracting cover to tension reinforcement from beam depth, that is 36 inch, 3 inch equals 33 inch. I am providing 12 number 8 reinforcing bars having total area of 9.42 inch square. This came from design result of beam. Depth to compression reinforcement is top cover of compression reinforcement. I am providing 6 number 8 compression reinforcement bars having total area of 4.71 inch square. This also came from design result of beam. Working UDL on beam which I calculated earlier is 1.89 kip per foot. Beam span is 48 feet. Excel sheet auto calculate each variable as I assign formulae to cells. FR is rupture strength, which is equal to 7.5 square root of FC prime. ES is modulus of elasticity of steel, which is 29,000 KSI. EC is modulus of elasticity of concrete and is equal to 57,000 square root of FC prime. N is modular ratio, which is ratio between modulus of elasticity of steel to modulus of elasticity of concrete. R and B are factors which we'll use to further calculate value of KD. IG is gross moment of inertia of section and is equal to BH cube over 12. MCR is cracking moment and calculate using this formulae. MA is working moment of pinned end beam at midspan and it is WL square over 8. ICR is cracking moment of inertia and calculate using this formulae. IE is effective moment of inertia and calculate using this formulae. This effective inertia, I will use in deflection calculation. 4 pinned end beam deflection at midspan equals to 5 over 384 multiply with WL to power 4 over ECIE. Result of deflection is 1.27 in. No need to provide camber in beam. As beam instantaneous deflection is in limit of allowable deflection of L/240, that is 2.4 inch. For long-term deflection, first calculate deflection due to sustained load. Sustained load includes self-weight or superimposed dead load. This factor is 2 for 5-year long-term deflection. Rho prime is percentage of compression reinforcement. Using long-term deflection formulae, result of long-term deflection comes to be 3.24 in after 5 years, which is greater than allowable limit of deflection. So I am now providing 1 inch camber to beam, resulting of beam instantaneous deflection reduce as well as long-term deflection reduces to 2.24 inch, which is less than allowable deflection limit. This is reinforcement detail of this 24 inch by 36 inch beam size. Want to see how to analyze and design minaret structure in ATABS V19? Click on card link showing top right of video. Now I am checking beam deflection of first floor, which has both side slab of 6 inch thick, so load on beam will increase due to increase in catchment length. Same span, concrete strength, steel yield strength, live load, and floor finish load for check deflection of this beam. Catchment length increase as there is now a right side slab also exist of 6 inch thick. I am increasing beam size to 24 inch by 42 inch. I am calculating slab self-weight acting on beam, equals to slab load, which is 0.075 kip per feet square into catchment length, that is 9.58 feet equals to 0.72 kip per foot. Floor finish load acting on beam equals to finish load, which is 0.036 kip per foot square into catchment length, which is 9.58 feet equals to 0.29 kip per foot. Calculating live load acting on beam, equals to live load of 0.1 kip per foot square into catchment length, which is 9.58 feet equals to 0.96 kip per foot. Beam self weight is concrete density, which is 0.15 kip per foot cube into cross sectional area of beam, which is 24 inch by 42 inch divided with 144, in which 144 is conversion factor from inch square to foot square. Result of this equals to 1.05 kip per foot. Service load will be 1.0 dead load plus 1.0 live load. Add all loads and it equals to 3.02 kip per foot. Ultimate load will be 1.2 dead load plus 1.6 live load. Result of this equals to 4.00 kip per foot. I am proceeding data to Excel sheet to calculate beam deflection. Input beam size to 24 inch by 42 inch with FC prime equals 3 KSI and FY equals 60 KSI. Depth of tension reinforcement is 39 inch, which I can calculate subtracting cover to tension reinforcement from beam depth, that is 42 to 3 equals 39 inch. I am providing 14 number 8 reinforcing bars having total area of 10.99 inch square. This came from design result of beam. Depth to compression reinforcement is top cover of compression reinforcement. I am providing 6 number 8 compression reinforcement bars having total area of 4.71 inch square. This also came from design result of beam. Working UDL on beam, which I calculated earlier, is 3.02 kip per foot. All values will auto-calculate in Excel sheet because I assign formulae to each cells. See beam effective moment of inertia is less than gross moment of inertia, reducing 38% than gross moment of inertia. In this case of loading on beam, result of instantaneous deflection is 1.26 inch. No need to provide camber in beam, as beam instantaneous deflection is in limit of allowable deflection of L over 240, that is 2.4 inch. Long-term deflection after 5 year is 3.28 inch, which is greater than allowable limit. So now I am providing 1 inch camber. Result is decrease in instantaneous and long-term deflection, which reduces to 2.28 inch less than allowable limit. This is reinforcement detailing of this beam of 24 inch by 42 inch. Want to see how to model suspension bridge in SAP 2000? Click on card link showing top right of video. Third beam deflection I am checking, as this beam has more catchment length from right side, and also slab thickness increases to 8 inch due to increase in slab span on right side. Same span, concrete strength, steel yield strength, live load, and floor finish load for check deflection of this beam. Catchment length increase as there is now right side slab span increase having 8 inch thickness. I am increasing beam size to 24 inch by 48 inch. Method is similar to calculating slab self-weight, floor finish load, live load on beam, just catchment length on beam increases, resulting more load on beam. Service load will be 1.0 dead load plus 1.0 live load. Add all loads and it equals to 3.88 kip per foot. Ultimate load will be 1.2 dead load plus 1.6 live load. Result of this equals to 5.13 kip per foot. I am proceeding data to Excel sheet to calculate beam deflection. Input beam size to 24 inch by 48 inch with FC prime equals 3 KSI and FY equals 60 KSI. Depth of tension reinforcement is 44 inch, which I can calculate subtracting cover to tension reinforcement from beam depth, that is 48 minus 4 equals 44 inch. I am providing 14 number 8 reinforcing bars having total area of 10.99 inch square. This came from design result of beam. Depth to compression reinforcement is top cover of compression reinforcement. I am providing 6 number 8 compression reinforcement bars having total area of 4.71 square inches. This also came from design result of beam. Working UDL on beam which I calculated earlier is 3.88 kip per foot. Beam span is 48 feet. All values will auto-calculate in Excel sheet because of assigned formulae in cells. See beam effective moment of inertia is less than gross moment of inertia reducing 45% to gross moment of inertia. In this case of loading on beam, result of instantaneous deflection is 1.23 inch. No need to provide camber in beam, as beam instantaneous deflection is in limit of allowable deflection of L/240 that is 2.4 inch. Long-term deflection after 5 year is 3.24 inch which is greater than allowable deflection limit. So I am providing 1 inch camber to beam from mid, result of this decrease in instantaneous as well as long-term deflection that reduces to 2.24 inch which is less than allowable limit. This is reinforcement detailing of 24 inch by 48 inch beam. Want to see how to design steel mezzanine floor in ATABS V19? Click on card link showing top right of video.
If you need any assistance in structural engineering or you want your structure to be redesigned, you can contact me through email address. Do like, share and subscribe to my channel and press bell icon so you will never miss any new video.